Hello everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel Trouble Free. In today's video, we are going to see some of the previously asked technical MCQs in Accenture recruitment process. As I have already explained the test pattern and all about Accenture, I said I'll be making a series of videos about the previously asked questions, right? So first video is about technical MCQs, and let's get started with the video. And if you have not yet subscribed to my channel, do subscribe and also hit whenever I post a new video, you can get notifications. And let's quickly get into the video now. A single line comment in C language source code begins with, and here are four options we have: slash, star, this is colon, this is double slash, and this is semicolon. So among these four options, what do you think is the answer? He's saying single line comment, right? So single line comment generally starts with this double slash. Generally, we use this also, but this is used in the case of multi-line comments, okay? So for single line comment, we use this C, option C, okay? And which of the following statement can be used to free the allocated memory in C? So in C language, which of the following statement is used to free the allocated memory? Free of variable name is used. See, the options we have is vanish, erase, remove, free. But actually, vanish and erase does not exist. They are not at all the keywords. So the answer is free of variable name is the answer for this, okay? And the next question we have is, to print a double value, which format specifier can be used? We have different format specifiers, right? So among them, in order to print a double value, we use this one, small lf. Generally, we don't get capital uppercase letters in format specifiers, right? We use only small letters, and for double we use percentile lf. And the next question is, which of the following is used to find and fix bugs in Java program? So in Java program, which of the following? JDK, what do you mean by JDK? It's a development kit, right? And what do you mean by JVM? JVM is Java Virtual Machine, and it is Java runtime environment. It provides runtime environment, and it is a virtual machine, and it provides all developer tools and all. Here JDB means Java debugger. So Java debugger is what we use to find out the used to find and fix the bugs in the Java program, okay? And it is mainly used for debugging the code. Next, in which process a local variable has same name as one of its instance variables? So in for this question, what could be the answer? If you know about the concept of variable shadowing, if you know what variable shadowing is, then you can easily answer this question. This is actually the definition of variable shadowing, okay? So local variable has name same as one of its instance variable, then in that case we call it as a variable shadowing, okay? And the next question we have is, which of the below is a fundamental data type in C++? In C++, among the four options, which is a fundamental data type, he's asking. We have options are boolean, union, structure, and none. Union and structure are also data types, but they are not fundamental data types. They are actually user defined data types, right? So the answer would be boolean. Boolean is a fundamental data type, primitive data type. Moving on to our next question, which of these operators is used to allocate memory for object? So as soon as seeing the options, you may feel like all like malloc, alloc are also correct, but here you have to notice, what you have to notice is, it is given as object here. So it, in the case of object, for example, let us take Java. In Java, how do you create an object? We use new keyword, right? So the answer is new. His malloc and alloc are also used for allocating memory, but they are used for dynamic memory allocation. But he is asking in the case of objects, right? So in the case of objects, we go with new keyword, okay? And next is a question related to database. Student ID, name, department name, and total credit. So these are the attributes. So these are the fields that are specified in student table. In this query, which attributes form the primary key? So among all the given attributes, which of them can form the primary key, is asking. What do you mean by primary key? Primary key is something with which we uniquely identify a table, right? So among these, ID, name, department name, and total credits. Name can be repeated. Two members can have same name, right? And department also. Under a department, you'll have 500 to 600 students. So obviously it is not a primary key. And coming to total credits, almost of so many students can have same number of credits, right? So total credits will also not be primary key and ID. Every student will have unique ID, right? ID number or roll number will not be repeated for any of the two students, right? So ID number can be taken as a primary key. Okay, primary key is something which is used to identify the value uniquely. Okay, find the output of the query. Again, a query is given, a simple query, select getDate is a query given. And what is the output of this? That means using this getDate function, what you can get? GetDate function is used to retrieve the current date and time of the system. So it returns the current date and time. So getDate is used to return the current date and time. So the option is B. Okay, all right. Next, 10th. Elements are removed from stack in dash order. This is our stack, right? So let us suppose we have 1, 2, 3. And if you want to remove the element, what do you do? First, you will be removing 3, and then you will be removing 2, and then you will be removing 1, right? So the order in which you have inserted is 1, 2, 3. The order in which you have removed is 3, 2, 1. That means what? You are deleting the elements, you are removing the elements from the stack in the reverse order. This is what you have to remember. Okay, so this is all about some of the basic MCQs, technical MCQs. Apart from this, we have MCQs related to Office, Microsoft Office, and we also have pseudocode questions. We also have network security and cloud computing questions. I'll be making all those videos. Videos about all those questions. So stay tuned to my channel for more and more videos related to Accenture. And if you're still having any doubts, let me know in the comment section or through my Instagram or through my Gmail account also. I'll be giving you my details in the description. You can contact me through that. And thank you for watching my video. Let's meet up soon in the next coming video with another topic. And also do let me know what are the next videos that I'm supposed to make in the comment section. And thank you for watching the video.